Chronosphere, and I think Ember fits that a lot more than the other melee heroes.
So Secret will take out the Slark, and once again, Secret will have the last overall pick. Still a bit of a potential for a twist at the end, as Bulba could take over the Marana or Elder Titan in the offlane, but probably going to be an offlaner coming out from Team Secret, whereas Na'Vi need their carry for Dit-Yara.
No, they...
Well, yeah, it could be a safe lane
Razor.
Yeah.
Okay, there's okay. Ember Mag. This is also a ridiculously good high ground defending team here from Na'Vi. And I don't know if Team Secret have the late game secured enough right now.
I think you actually need to, you have to fight, you have to push early versus Ember Mag, Winter Wyvern faces Void. Like, if once it goes late game, these heroes destroy BKBs, mass armor, yeah. Like team fight with refresher. It like really doesn't matter. I think like you'll have it in the bag if you're Na'Vi and it goes past 45. It's just incredibly difficult.
Secret
to
can still come back with, okay, the so battle. They are going to come back with the traditional offlane. We talked about the Tide and his potential. Matt Draskill, really quick, takes this one.
I'm actually have put Secret in the same spot they were in game two. I'm going to say Na'Vi had the better draft.
All right. Ben, what do you think here? I like this Secret lineup a lot, but this just feels to me, this lineup from Na'Vi feels like it fits their classic formula, and it always also gives them a lot of potential to scale going into the late game.
I favor Secret just because Drow Ranger has consistently been winning games. They lacked a tower hitter last game. I think that was the missing piece, and now they found the solution to the puzzle.
Okay, very even draft. I'll go with Na'Vi. Ben's going to go for Secret. With that, our series is tied 1-1. One of these teams is looking to take control in game three. Throw it over to LD and Winter for our cast.
Thank you, Alan. That's right. I'm ready to go.
Na'Vi. Dit-Yara, Ember.
Didn't sound very confident, but you reluctantly say Na'Vi.
I reluctantly say Na'Vi. Don't put stuff in my mouth, you know. I don't...
Anyway, so Secret running the Bulba Tidehunter here. They are getting the Drow again. Their dire side. Why Na'Vi? It seems like a lot rests on Art Style's shoulders this game to me.
As usual, the early game is always on their supports. And we have seen time and time again when they have Enchantress, they're always able to take control of the laning phase, and SD is not the best of okay. They're gonna get a disrupt. This should be first blood.
Oh, Sonego, far away from home. And he will die. The last hit going to Arteezy here.
Granted to Arteezy. Everyone stop attacking.
So. What teamwork?
What teamwork? I am always gonna grant you a kill if I gank someone.
Thank you, friend. Secret.
Only if you carry me later.
I can't promise that. I'll take the kill. I'll do my best. So Na'Vi here, like, if it, let's say it does go a bit later on, both these lineups have some potential to scale. Do you think Na'Vi just straight up wins late game?
Na'Vi
We've
wins.
Seen Drow being a lot stronger in the late game than she
Not
used to be.
Against Empower, Ember Spirit. No, I don't think so.
No chance. Okay.
And they have Chrono, so I think their late game is just like there's a curse as well. So overall, their late game is very strong. So I don't really think that Secret wants to go late game. Maybe at tops, 35 minutes, 40 minutes, but anything apart more than that is not very good for them.
So we do see Arteezy with I guess I'm gonna almost call it his patented move now. I'm just starting with the TP and you know, getting there in time to block the creep wave, so his supports are free to do other things. Let's crit that bounty rune. Off to a good start here. Top lane, we are seeing General on the Void, but he's up against a tri lane for now.
This lane is really bad for him.
Is there how much kill potential is there in this lane?
Yeah, but he's not going to be able to get like farm in the lane against those heroes. He has to wait for Enchantress to head over with the creep. And if you look at
there's an observer to scout it.
There's a sentry blocking the camp as well.
Yes. Yep. I believe it is in the box.
This is really important. I don't see teams do this enough against Na'Vi when they have their Enchantress or Chen. You need to block the camp near the offlane, and Magnus is gonna...
Oh, Denvi taking a beating here by Arteezy, who already used the arrow. Not gonna go for it just yet. Setting up. But yeah, every Artstyle Enchantress and Chen game I've seen, it's always the offlane he goes to. Yep. He doesn't really pressure mid anymore. He hasn't been pressuring the safe lane, it's always the off lane.
Most of the Enchantress champions in the current patch, even DJ does the same thing on Fnatic. They prioritize on helping the off lane in most situations because it just allows the off laner, like, for example, like a Void. If the or Enchantress is not here, he's not going to be able to get farm or get experience. But when the channel Enchantress is here, it's going to allow him to get some farm and some experience, and it's going to help him a lot in the game later.
So, looking at the Radiant safe lane now, how do you see this lane developing with the Ember Spirit matched up against the Tide? No help for Dayara for the time being. Bulma's going to get a lot of farm here,
I mean,
it looks
he's
like.
He's always getting sacked a lot. Ember against Tide is fine. He's not going to get pressured too much by the Tide, but Tide is going to get farm because it's a 1v1 matchup. Courier going down. Awesome. Mr. Soneko, the Courier Sniping King.
This guy, he must have like the highest average Courier Snipes per game of any Tier 1 player. It's ridiculous how often he kills it off.
Highlighter used to be that as well, like when he picked Bounty Hunter.
He doesn't get those heroes anymore, but this might cost them heavily here, Winter. Soneko's in quite far. The arrow's not going to connect, but Puppy giving him the old staple gun, and now the Wyvern's been brought down.
He's
very low. Could maybe deny the neutrals.
Yeah, he might suicide the neutrals.
He can maybe embrace again.
Even if he dies here, it's worth it. He's
the tree. No one else coming in, and there's no mana for the combo for Puppy here. Is maybe gonna get hit one more time, but Soneko with the boots gonna make it out. Instead, they'll turn the other way. They're gonna look for Artstyle, the Enchantress, but General's here to support. They'll chase after Pilot Eye. The time walk through, pretty good position there by General. Just looking for a bash. He does have it skilled up and not even required. Rejoining the fray, Soneko not only nets his team a courier kill, but also a hero kill as well.
Gosh. He didn't even leave the fight, he was just nearby to even help his team get the kill there. Some miscommunication from Secret there, like Pilotline wanted to use the disrupt to kill the Enchantress, so Puppy was not in there to actually land his Storm, otherwise they would have netted the kill onto our Storm.
They're all doing pretty well here despite being sacked. 13-4 versus the Tide. Bulba only 11-4.
I mean, it's okay lane for him as long as he uses the Flame Guard every time it's up to get CS and to zone the Tide away. And Tide at the same time, once the Flame Guard is down, he should be able to get relatively easy CS with his Anchor Smash.
Ah, they have seen Artstyle though. Pilot out with a clever ward around the tree line. Can they do much about it though? Puppy's off near the mid lane right now. Looks like they want to contest Dendi. Well, sidestep the Arteezy arrow. And now poor Poppy that Invis Rune as he looks to retreat. Not seeing the double empower skill build this time around from, I think it was Sumail earlier in the tournament who did that.
Yeah, he was jungling early in the game because he couldn't lane.
Yeah.
That was not a good game for his Magnus. That game was very difficult for them. So right now Soneko all the way towards the bottom lane to maybe set up a kill on the Ember.
This ward is doing work though already. Sees all the Enchantress's movements, gives Puppy a reason to go up there. But meanwhile, Bulba in the bottom lane gets clipped by the chains. They continue to emulate him. Dayara trying to play with the tower range, but it's top lane where they start to converge on General. He salved up. He's waiting for the cooldown here on that time walk. About 5 seconds to go. The spear will come back, and in come the Enchantress creeps. Art's now getting hit a little bit. A Pilot Die trying to work on him with the poison, but the bash! Very timely from General, secures the kill. Artstyle might even make it out. He barely falls here, but another bash onto Envy, looking for more. If he gets one more bash, he might get this kill too with the creeped cooldowns soon to come. But I'll not risk it with the Shadow Demon respawn being so low. Still though, the pressure is on Envy. 23 CS, still doing well here, but he may struggle if they keep it up. Meanwhile, bottom onto Bulba again. Soneko. Working together with Dayara to force Pilot Eye that way, and this does free up that top lane if Artstyle wants to go there. As the slow from the Wyvern comes through, Dayara into the trees, but the poison's gonna give them the vision they need, and now the disruption follows it up. Another poison, there's the embrace, the Ravage committed! Bulba says, screw you, man, and takes him down. Dayara will drop. Very nice usage of the early Ravage there by Bulba. And good rotation by Pilot Eye to score a kill.
Yeah, that was a really, really big kill on the enemy team's carry there. Turning that gank around towards their favor, so very well played by Secret. Good rotation once more.
Yeah, fast level 6 as well, with nobody to share the experience with for Bulba.
So right now, Enchantress, let's see whether he moves back towards the Void lane with the creep. Hand of Midas.
Naked even. It's always an early grab for Artstyle and Puppy, but normally not this early.
I mean, if you think about their game plan, they want to draw the game super late, so going a Midas is playing towards that plan for them.
Oh, Dendi skewering. Arteezy back under the tier 2 tower, then RPing him as well, but the stomp comes through. Might be able to make it out Artor, but then from the side comes the Enchantress. There's the haste pop. Did have the raindrops there to help secure his retreat, but still, Dendi, He was forced to commit an RP, but he avoids the gank, and he buys time for that Enchantress to continue farming.
Yeah, Bulba meanwhile still having a great time at bottom lane despite the supports leaving him alone for the time being. Chronosphere not up yet for general, so...
The one thing I would say, Winter, is they're very lacking on damage to put in the Chrono until later on in the game.
Yeah.
They don't have that Lina or Leshrac.
Enchantress would be the one that can deal. Enchantress can do a lot of damage later during the Chrono, and not to mention when Battle Fury comes online for the Ember Spirit with the Empower.
Yeah, but this stage of the game will be a lot tougher as a Radiant Scan is deployed top. Trying to see if there's anyone creeping up from the side of Secret. Not the case, though. The Midas is close. What's the next big timing that you look at here? We'll have the Chronosphere coming soon. The Ravage will cool down fairly in short order. Is there a particular move you're expecting from either team?
Ravage is one of them, and with the Draw Ranger acquiring her levels and her ultimate now, Secret wants to play a faster paced game since Na'Vi is much stronger in the late game.
Oh, the chains aren't gonna connect here, but Bulba still getting caught out by the Shockwave. The pursuit continues. Will he be able to bring him down? No, the Flame Guard not enough. And Pilai Dai looks to turn this one around. Stomp. Well, by Puppy, now the Spirit will return. And then Dendi, after a failed rotation, now the Ravage is online. So round two could be a lot scarier. Bulba just very tanky.
They have to bring sentries for the Moonlight. It's the second time that someone escaped because there's no detection there, so...
We saw even last game when Secret had to deal with the Invoker, Ghostwalk, and Bounty Hunter that later on in the game, it's hard to keep up with it, but... First debut of the Moonlight Shadow, successful there.
Yep. 8-minute Midas on Artstyle.
And he applies the pressure top, but... He may get punished for this. He's a slow one. Great troll trap on the way out. The arrow. Artstyle dodging bullets. This Bambi is tough to tango with. They can't quite finish him off, but the creep will be taken down. Still Artesia to rotate for that. Freeze up the Magnus on mid, the Ember Spirit bottom. Artstyle getting away with murder.
So Na'Vi still, like you mentioned, severely lacking in terms of damage if they want to look to set things up with the Chrono. It's not very easy for them to get any kills at the moment. Like I mentioned, Enchantress with her level 6 would be the best solution to add damage into the Chronosphere, which she's going to acquire soon.
Yeah, she's about to get that impetus. Also, we'll have the boots now, so I can actually chase a bit. I'm trying to give Sonaco his experience in this mid lane. We'll see if Arteezy has a fish with the arrow, but... Waiting for the Star Storm to cool down. So a very plodding mid game now developing. But General looks to change that equation. He moves top. He does have the Chronosphere online. The ward scouted his movement. But not gonna die for it, just contesting the farm a bit of Puppy.
Yeah, the next thing for Seeker is just to find a timing to get Roshan as soon as possible with the draw. That's going to be, I think, their most important task. And right now, Sonaco...
Oh, Arteezy. Great shot there with the arrow, the DD rune, and the Drow arrow. That's a lot of physical damage. Didn't even need the Star Storm.
Yep. A good pickup there by Arteezy, getting that kill. But overall, for Secret, they still have to keep playing a very fast-paced game with the Drow Ranger. They cannot allow Na'Vi to just get their levels and items, especially the dagger on the Magnus. At a good time.
Seems they agree. They're gonna make their move on mid here right now. Sonaco gonna slow Arteezy down. Maybe not actually going in, but just trying to stop this push. Tier 1 though, under siege and will be last hit by Arteezy. He jumps away, had the Shadow Demon there to protect him on Miwa on the top lane. Other action breaking out as Dendi skewers Bulba back under tower. RP already expended, it looks like, but not even close to a kill. So they commit a lot just to hold this tower for now, and meanwhile Secret setting up shop for kills elsewhere. Sonaco disrupted into an arrow, Starstorm's there, Arteezy secures another. So this Mirana already very active, very effective, the leader in net worth, having all kinds of impact around the map. And looking for Dendi too, has the level 2 arrow ready. Wants to zone him out, secure this tower, Ravage still available. Na'Vi are getting pushed down hard, Winter.
I mean, Secret are stronger right now, so unless they have their Blink on Magnus and all their ultimates up, they are not going to be able to take a fight. I don't think. He's not that far away from his dagger on Dendi, 600 away. So before that happens, it's going to be difficult for Na'Vi to take any fight, so Secret fully understanding the situation, are trying to press forward to gain more advantage.
Oh, Envy. He does get the silence off here. And Bulba's quick to rotate, and Na'Vi realizing as soon as they make a move on Envy, there will be backup. And it comes in spades.
Yeah, the other thing is Bulba is also getting a mech for his team, so that it's gonna allow Secret to play a much faster paced game, group up, take towers. Stun onto General there, needs to land the silence.
Gets the silence on General as well, but DRR moves in. They have that Ravage. But Na'Vi also a very elusive bunch of heroes, so you gotta be careful about when you top it.
They were anticipating that Secret were going to move into the Roshan pit right there with the draw plus the Ravage, but Secret are going to be very wary of things and they're going to continue sieging the tier 1 at bottom.
This will be big winter. Dendi getting hunted by the Cat Lady. Pretty much guaranteed a double star fall here. Will Dendi at least get his blink in time? With this creep wave, he should have the gold for it. The arrow connects, just barely clipping him from around the trees.
Oh,
Dendi RPs, but it doesn't matter. And the blink is deferred. A huge pick again from Artor. He is really getting the job done right now for Secret.
And he's playing so well. The first game where he chose to go for Vanguard on the Void, and right now in this game once more in the first 15 minutes of the game, getting a very crucial kill for his team.
He's been all over the map, and he's still the leader in net worth with a very timely Aghanim Scepter. Under construction at this rate.
They're hitting their timing very
soon. Basically got it.
Aghanim's mech on Tide and whatever items on draw, so.
Oh, this would be costly though if he goes down Remnant.
Remnant too far! Oh my god!
They needed that so bad. Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good. And this time, Artesia is both.
Man, that sucks so much. That was so close. That could have been such a huge kill after losing their Magnus, now General, trying to get revenge for
his
team.
This one could be as well, but there's going to be an Echo Stomp coming from the north. Can Puppy turn it around?
Detection!
He gets the stomp off. Where is the vision? They actually have a sentry, but the Ravage comes around to cancel it and counter this initiation. General just says, screw it, I'm going in for Envy, but he loses the true sight. Envy's moved out of the vision of that sentry ward, and now he gets turned on with the Frost Arrows. The Radiant Courier is sacrificed as well upon the Altar of Secret, and still the Wyvern drops. Now Deira's on the run. And they're doing all of this before the Mirana gets into the fight.
Man,
Arteezy has arrived. It's snowballing for Secret.
This is turning into the Arteezy show on his Mirana right here. Being at the right place at the right time, escaping the gang, getting a 40-minute Aghanim's. And as the mech as well on Bulba there, proving to be very crucial, keeping his carry, the Draw Ranger, alive.
Even just using the pounce there for that extra bit of attack speed.
Efficiency, Gorman.
Secret wanting to take this tower down as quickly as possible. And the graph plunges Secret's way.
Now they have full map control on the bottom side, the area that's very close to Roshan. Oh, General getting consolation prize. The courier on the way out.
You kill my courier, I'll kill yours, he says.
But Secret...
But he may die. It's to the far side of the creep wave. Na'Vi are getting a little
blink
more...
blink RP though.
A little more careful. Arteezy, I believe, does have the eggs now, so he is going to be very tough to burst. So we see Dayarok committing up top. He wants this tower. Is he going to come back in for it? He doesn't want to tank the aggro. A lip bulb would get the deny.
He's
and now he
reengages. He's waiting for Magnus.
Magnus is going to be there in a moment. Dendi blinks in, trying to hold on to that RP, but Bulba has the mech. He may be forced to commit it along with a skewer, or they may just not go for the kill. And here's it'll be the ladder. While that's happening, bottom lane, Artstyle getting focused. Even with that extra bit of HP from the Ogre Club, it's not enough. Good combo there from Secret. Finding the kill, not even needing the disruption, and able to save it for the defensive retreat.
Man, this Mirana is just all over the place.
Only 4-0-2, which isn't that crazy at this stage, but it's just all been crucial kills, delaying the blink timing.
You say only 4-0-2, his team has 8 kills.
Yeah. It's more that they've been crucial kills that lead to towers, that, you know, delay a blink dagger. They're coming at the right time for Secret.
And this Enchantress is just food for the Aghanims on the Mirana. He needs to be able to get more items and increase his HP pool to be able to survive that in teamfights. Like a Ravage with the Elder Titan Spirit next to him with the double Star Storm. He's just gonna just evaporate in the team fight.
Now Puppy. So, grabbing that medallion in Secret, they do want to Rosh.
Yep, finally.
Got the Frost Armor creep here. Got that extra bit of armor to work with. Even though Na'Vi have all their ultimates ready, they're still lacking in the damage department. They'll look for a puppy pick off here though. Blink into skewer, good combo. Bash follow up and get the kill. Or actually, sorry, I think that was the RP. Yeah, the RP does get deployed there.
Well, this game, getting a Crimson Guard on puppy will be extremely, extremely important. It's very good versus all the cleave damage, the Ember, plus the Empower and the Battle Fury.
Yeah, the Frost Armor creep's gonna help as well. So, yeah. I mean, Secret, they definitely know how to deal with physical damage. We've seen that before.
Vlad's Crimson Guard, all the team items at some point. So Aegis is gonna be acquired onto RTZ right now, and Tityara still pretty far away from his Battle Fury.
It just takes a long time to get that first big item on the Ember. I mean, can Na'Vi even keep up in farm? Like, as much as they have great farming heroes of Secret, take all these Doubter Towers.
I mean, I would say they have pretty good heroes to slow down the push. Splinter Blast plus Shockwave from Magnus, good deep push. So before the Battle Fury comes online, they're gonna have those two spells to slow down the push.
Arteezy moves in, aggressively posting up in front. General will time walk off that initial volley of damage. Arteezy now forced to run, but the impetus is rain in. And he gets in there with the silence. Bulba just wrangling about on the backside, but they're trying to set up the stomp combo. They hit, the arrow won't connect though. And now Arteezy moves in a bit deeper. The chains come through. He still has the Aegis. They don't want to lose it this early, but the shockwave will ensure that they do. And then the chrono gets dropped, isolating Bulba. There won't be a ravage this fight unless that disruption is absolutely perfect. He gets it off, but still he will fall. A well-timed sleight of fist there, slicing up the watermelon. And now Arteezy held in position on life number two. Do they chase for more? Another stomp from Puppy. Secret are forced to disengage.
And what a chrono there by General. And that was a very, very good chrono, allowing them to take down the Tide before he gets his Ravage off and locking down the other two heroes as well at the end of it.
Yeah, well-timed sleight of fist there as well. Didn't have a good Ravage opportunity when he came out of
there
disruption.
There was a big hole. Secret were really strong with that timing and the Aegis on Arteezy. So it's going to allow Na'Vi to have a lot more time to farm up even more items on their heroes.
Battle Fury. No longer a distant dream. He's getting close, has the two big components. Well on his way to the Perseverance here. Na'Vi will make their next move. It's towards top.
SD might just be dead here if he's not getting out soon.
He sticks around. Pile I die. Bit too long, and they're not even going to hesitate. RP committed. Quick skewer. Pile driving him back in. Shockwave. As well as the Splinter Blast. Secure it.
Yeah, basically, their ultimates right now, any pickoff they can get from it is just okay for them because they are looking to draw the game out. So any pickoff is crucial for them to have more time for the rest of the heroes to actually farm more items. In certain games, you would say that you want to save the ultimates for a big team fight, get more kills with it. But in the kind of game that Na'Vi wants to play right now, it's okay for them to get any kills with all their big cooldowns.
Yeah, as long as Secret can't immediately go high ground off of it, but they were not in position to do so there. So Secret will have to slow down a little bit.
Man, they don't want to slow down with their heroes.
No. They don't have a choice, Winter. Do you have to wait for the next Aegis at this point? Or do you think Secret can roll the dice?
The safest play, but I think with the lineup that Na'Vi has, they need to be able to push forward even without the Aegis. They need to be like pushing and trying to get towers and limiting where Na'Vi can farm. The other issue is like they don't have the best heroes to actually catch out a hero like Ember when he's farming. They have to land like a silence from a draw, which is not something that you want against an Ember.
I mean, I suppose later, much later, Mirana can get a hex, but that is not a great solution.
Bulba. Okay, he's not gonna chase forward, so not gonna find anyone there. I mean, you talk about that hex, it's probably gonna be...
It's gonna like be much later.
An ultra late game item, I think.
But like you said, Drow Ranger, not reliable lockdown by any means. Na'Vi do close in on the Battle Fury for Dayron. That's gonna be a big tipping point for them as far as pushing the lanes out goes. Puppy here in the bottom lane, gonna get... Oh, doesn't get hit by the Splinter Blast, so Seneca won't follow up on that, but does usher him away. Try to hold this tier 2 as long as possible. Their Void still off in the top side of the map. Doesn't look like Na'Vi want to defend this tower, but they are in the area. Draw illusions, just chipping away.
I mean, talking about the illusions, in the late game they do have the Enchantress to deal with the illusions later. Can always take away. the illusions from the SD or even the potential Manta style on the draw. So they have some good ways of dealing with the illusions, not only the cleave.
The era. Battle Fury is basically done now after this wave will have it. And I believe they have the maximum power at this point as well.
Yeah.
So the farming will intensify unless Secret can pin Na'Vi down inside their base.
It's not like the farming that worries them the most right now, it's like the scaling, like all the heroes of Na'Vi scale so well into the late game. So Secret has to press forward. I'm not sure if you go for the Aghanims and Maelstrom on the Drow, like we've seen in a couple of games, that how much damage can the Drow dish out later in the game? Is it going to be enough against what Na'Vi have?
I mean, that's great for like clearing Terrorblade illusions we've seen.
Yeah, not so good against man fighting, I guess, against a FV Ember lineup.
And they also just have great gap closing, even the mag with the four staff. They are going to be able to get on the Drow, and it's up to the Tide and the Shadow Demon to deal with that.
Yeah, I think Secret has to play very well in those situations to be able to come out on top. They need to outplay, outmaneuver, land their arrows and Echo Storms on crucial targets.
Bulba moves out here in the bottom lane. But Secret are coming. They're very close to the Bulba blink. Want to secure it. Maybe find some kills. Dendi, the man to break the smoke. He blinks out right as the spirit comes in, and they've also found someone else. Arteezy snipes out Artstyle, so they still get the one pick.
You know, if Artstyle was not getting ganked there, I'm sure they would be more
attentive,
aware to Dendi. Yeah, Dendi being the smoke next breaking. To them. They were like most likely all looking at the enchantress there, and Dendi pops out at the side, and no one notices.
Next time, maybe Bulba with this blink will be able to catch him. The farm will continue. De'era, 1300 gold up. There's already a Solar Crest to deal with. A butterfly is coming, so an early MKB may be. Well, I guess it could be the shotgun actually for Arteezy. I guess we'll see.
The shotgun is good versus the Chrono as well. Disruption.
See what he wants
to
do.
Oh, he blocks the arrow!
Dendi blinking into the arrow!
He blocks the arrow!
But does block it. A noble sacrifice, I suppose.
I mean, he's just doing that just to save the Ember there, so making sure that his carry, his big brother there, stays alive. Or the machine, he would call him. The Ditya machine.
The tractor. He's still getting tuned up a little bit. They're not ready for full deployment, but soon those crops will be ready for harvest. If it has his way.
Yep, Secret continually to press forward with their lineup, the Drow lineup. Trying to secure another tower for their team. With the Blink Ravage, they feel really, really confident in taking the tower down. And the next Roshan is up, right? Is the Roshan up?
So it is indeed the E-Blade. Tons of magic damage now from Arteezy.
Yeah, basically after this is just to go back and secure Roshan when it spawns and proceed to the high ground.
Yeah, Na'Vi are now tucked away in their own
base.
They're
expecting the Roshan maybe. They just smoked. Roshan is going to start spawning.
Secret do have a couple of reasonably placed wards here on the Na'Vi side of the map, so it's going to be tough to find a pick off before Secret start to get itchy feet and back away. And leading with Sineko here, our Eternal Envy sees him coming. He's gonna drop a ward and the jig's already up. The old Moonlight Shadow, they'll back away. Meanwhile in the mid lane, Arteezy hunting Te'era.
Oh, he needs a lockdown
Flame Guard
for his kill. Or land his arrow.
On some cooldown here, so they might be able to get the kill. Arrow comes through the leap. The shotgun.
My
See
God.
Ya!
What a player.
Arteezy, no hesitation, just mows him
Man,
down.
That movement towards the side of the trees to set up that arrow was perfect. That was perfect.
That was magnificent. Arteezy continuing to deliver here.
Man, he's in really, really good shape. We see a purge onto General here. They're trying to set up a fight here for Secret.
There's the blink out, the purge damage taking on a split second too late, but still they're going to chase a bit further. Looking for Artstyle.
They should be able to get Enchantress.
They have that Yasha move speed puppy there to cut them off. The arrow comes through. It's a slight miss. Till TP out, he's going to force some sort of reaction. The stomp gets there in time. Then, for good measure, the disruption. So, say goodbye to your Artstyle. On top of that, they also sniped that Radiant Courier as it retreated. Got a little bit of extra gold. Secret, it's starting to add up for them. Score 5-12, Na'Vi. We've yet to really see that big combo, Winter, that RP, Chrono, Sleight of Fist with impetuses raining down. I mean, the hell, the Wyvern, we've not seen them chain these abilities together, but they may have to soon because Secret are pushing in.
I think they should do the Roshan first. I saw a creep earlier, so I think Secret already know that Roshan is up. So, I mean, obviously that's the safest play. Secure the Aegis before you go for the high ground. There's no need to force anything right now.
I'll secure the Ancients, then secure the Aegis.
Yeah,
Ancients,
go on, secure. Ancients, towers, last hit, just a typical carry player. Take everything from the support. Take everything from the enemy team.
Yes, Starvation Dota. It's the secret way. It's not just me, you know. But now they go into the pit. They've got the Morana there. Bulba beside him. Does Na'Vi fight into this? Can they fight into this?
If they land a good Chrono, plus Magnus RP.
Anything is possible. Also, what kind of detection does Na'Vi have here? They don't have a gem, do they?
They have sentries on the ground, so at the very least, they have that going for them.
Envy is far in there. He's a confident little one. That Draw Ranger gonna get caught up by the chains here to start. But the Chrono comes from behind. The BKB, Isolated Arteezy. Envy gets kept away from his team. He needs a little help here. Sonako gets the curse off, and it causes the carries to turn against each other. Envy's pretty tanky, but the Imps will finish him off. Arteezy now looking to turn the fight. A good RP. Sleight of Fist as well, but do they have the follow-up damage? Puppy, low, not dead yet. Brings him down and then jumps away. Can he kill Bulba on the way out? No, Arteezy will force him back. Pi, though, gonna be kill number three. The combo was solid, and Arteezy can't find that third kill. So all three cores surviving for Na'Vi.
There was
only the Morana for Secret.
There was such a manly play there. I'm not sure if that was intended. He just ran up the ramp there.
Leading with the draw, you mean?
Yeah, leading with the draw was rather like bold from Envy. He wanted to give his team vision so they can understand whether they should ravage or follow up with an Elder Titan stomp. But then Na'Vi follow up with a very good Chrono, like general block off the ramp. So no one could actually run up to actually assist the Draw Ranger, which was caught up alone.
I think he was just banking on like, even if I get caught, I just BKB here, and then they ravage and or disrupt to save me.
I mean, the other thing was during the BKB time, he got cursed. He was the main curse target, and Arteezy was around him. So most of the time on the BKB were wasted, and Arteezy laying on him at the same time.
Oh, teams will be collecting themselves here as we lose four players.
Internet problems, Mr. Gorman.
Well,
at the house.
If it was the internet entirely, then everyone would presumably disconnect.
So whose fault is it?
I'm sure we can blame you, Winter. Somehow.
Wow.
I mean, Charlie's here. Charlie just walked in.
I mean,
and
I would love,
then it crashed.
I
so.
Would love to have the ability to crash the PCs when I'm sitting down here with you.
Why would you love having that ability so much?
Yeah, then I would crash your Overwatch games when I'm just playing downstairs.
Thanks, Winter. Appreciate the love. As always. But Puppy looking pretty calm. See a lot of talking from both teams here. They're getting reset back into the game. Looks like Pi wants a moment.
Have you ever seen Puppy not calm? No.
I've seen him pretty upset before. I mean, every competitive player gets upset at times.
Every Dota player gets angry. Except for Gorman, because he's such a saint.
I get very angry.
I know, right?
You are a big rager, though. Despite your seemingly calm and polite demeanor,
well,
you have been caught flaming.
I do not rage harder than you.
Many a time at the BTS.
I do not slam my keyboard. I do not throw my mouse around.
No, you just slam your teammates verbally.
You're just lucky BTS is rich so they could provide you with more keyboards and mouse.
Someday your LAN cafe will provide us with more keyboards and mice.
Oh yeah, I wish.
But
someday, Gorman, someday. If that ever happens.
Somewhere over the rainbow.
That will be the day Gorman becomes a calm Dota player. Relax, team, we're doing fine.
You need to bring that competitive fire and intensity, Winter. If you're too calm,
it's all but gone.
You lack passion.
It's all but gone.
Yeah, you've definitely lost your passion. You haven't even played a game of Dota in how many months now? Shh. Marriage is not an excuse.
classified information, Garmin. Lord Dank, please.
So, all right, let's take stock of the game here, Winter. 8-14 the score. Secret with a medium-sized lead around 29 minutes. You've already said you think Secret do not have the late game.
Yep, I said at tops, you do not want the game to go past 40 minutes. Like 35 to 40 minutes is like the maximum time for Secret's lineup against the Empowered Ember and the Chronosphere. I mean, they're going to have a refresher for that. I think that is as good as it gets for Secret's lineup, the refresher on Bulba.
And then pretty much from there, it's kind of a...
Yeah, if they do not
downward
get
spiral.
Rex, yeah. At least at that point, then it's going to be difficult.
The other thing is Na'Vi just have... they have the Ember, so they have that like mobility to keep the lanes pushed out pretty easily.
Yeah, they have to try and like siege with the refresher and try to force them to come in and just initiate with Ravage. And make sure that he does not get caught in the Chronosphere. That is extremely crucial for them.
So, teams are ready. Na'Vi on pauses. And we get back into it. Roshan's still lurking there to be claimed.
Illusion. I can sense the illusion game going to happen.
Getting the Yasha here. So we're not going to see that Dagon.
Manta, Mirana, Manta, Draw Ranger, Disrupt. Good luck.
Do you like that better than just like all inning on the single target burst, like the Dagon build?
Not sure though, because Na'Vi's heroes are very well equipped at dealing with illusions. They have Splinter Blast, they have the Enchant from Art Style.
Empower,
Battle Fury.
Yeah. Oh, nice deny there by Envy though.
Well, it's something.
From the trees. But it is still a tier 1 going down. A little map control lost here. The Secret Roche. Na'Vi not in position to contest this. They do get another tower though. Tier 2 going down top as well. That one, no, not denied. I'll give this Aegis to Arteezy. So Envy will really have to mind his positioning.
The rune of many winds, Mr. Gorman would say.
This is the God's rune. And yeah, pub game has been won by just waiting for a double damage rune to spawn and backdooring. But we're not quite at that point.
Oh, pub games are won when you wait for your enemy to feed.
You know it's gonna happen sooner or later. Here we go though. Arteezy was out and they were definitely thinking about a jump on him with the Wyvern lurking in the trees, but needed more heroes to try to back him up first. See a Diffusal Blade on General now. So item progression continues here.
Na'Vi's doing the right thing, keeping all the lanes pushed up. Like every small little move you see Soneko doing here, keeping the creep wave away from their base is so crucial.
Oh, they're hunting
team.
Him though, Elder Titan.
How?
He was like,
how?
Just a centimeter away from getting stomped there.
That's why you go to gym. Make sure that you're slim and fit.
Hey, the Wyvern has some pretty big wings, man. I would not call him slim, although I meant.
Yeah, I would not call you slim.
thanks, buddy.
Sorry, I'm rude.
I have a plate mail.
I'm not being tactful.
No, that you definitely are not. You guys are seeing the real Winter. But we all have to find out what the real Secret looks like here. Do they have that killer instinct? They showed it in game 1. They struggled in game 2. And here we are in game 3. Series tied up 1-1.
Did they get the refresher on Tide yet? Does he have it?
Don't
I mean,
so.
Like, yeah, they're pushing without the refresher, I guess.
They're committing for this.
Yeah, he's actually very close. Huh, I'm surprised they're not gonna wait for it. Like, if you're getting a big item like that, usually you yell at your team, guys, relax, I need 100 gold.
Oh, Arteezy gonna get caught, skewered way back, leaps on out. The stomp is there to cover his retreat, but if they can just finish him off once, get rid of this Aegis, it'll be a big win. He blinks out though, he does survive, the Greaves come through, but General on the case. He isolates Bulba, can they finish off the Tide? They're unsure of who to go for, they think once, twice about it, then they turn back. They want to bring Bulba down, the PKB still there, the RP follow up, Bulba gets off the Ravage though! It hits the whole team, it's too late, it looks like Envy, now cursed, focus down, and Arteezy turn against them, the disruption to prevent the kill during curse, but one more imp will get the job done. And Deira on the back line still finding kills, so they've gotten rid of the Aegis, they've killed off the Drow, they have managed to bring down that Tidehunter,
really,
and they hold the base.
They should have waited for the refresher. Now it's gonna take some time before he gets it because he lost his life.
Oh, disruption here, and running the other way, General does get caught, shotgun down by Arteezy. Are we getting a little too big for their britches, perhaps? They exit the base. And then Sineko gets found out, tries to juke. Can't juke Mr. 9K. Godlike, he has yet to die this game. Winter.
They had like the false sense of security.
Oh, is the Jinx here? I think the Jinx is here. He leaps out the self shotgun for the save, but the chase continues from Dayara. Gonna burn him down soon. Slide of fist. One more right click.
No.
Oh god. It's Arteezy's turn to just feed away a gigantic pile of gold to Na'Vi. Two games in a row now where Secret held a very solid lead and it appears like it might be slipping away. No racks. Not good enough for them.
Well, this is something similar to what happened in the second game where they were sieging.
And they're looking for more, then they find Puppy as well. He's in far, Shockwave and dead. The collapse appears like it might be inbound.
This is real
and
bad.
Now the refresher, but now to deal with it, a Magnus BKB as well.
Why didn't they wait for the refresher, Goblin? Why?
That's a question for smarter Dota minds than I.
Come on, give yourself more credit.
Oh, now you're trying to suck up to me. Get the hell out of here. You're dead to me, Winter. The tower is dead to Dayara as well.
Please don't forget to come.
One way or another.
To Malaysia in December.
Don't forget to come to your wedding, Wise. You can flame the shit out of me. Oh no, thank you.
I promise I won't do that on that day. I promise.
But I think importantly for Na'Vi, after winning that fight, they get back to work as far as getting these lanes pushed out. Dayara shoves in bottom, top lane, Dendi pushes that lane out. They're ensuring that Secret can't just go right back for a push and potentially take a lane of Rax, and now they have all their big ultimates ready to go, so not sure if Secret want to be playing offensively right now.
I mean, they have to. The longer they wait, it's not going to get easier. It's just going to get harder and harder and harder. The more items Ember gets, the push just becomes very, very difficult.
This Ember is already hitting extremely hard. 300 plus damage before the crit.
Yep. Unless somehow they catch the Ember in the Ravage.
Oh, which okay. They might! Yeah, he obliges here. Blake's in. Bulba instantly rearms the Ravage. He popped the Refresher immediately. He's going to TP home. Ember does have buyback. Can they force it though?
Okay.
70 seconds.
Moonlight Shadow is the somehow they catch the.
They need to go home here. Na'Vi, they stuck around a bit too long and they might get punished, Sineko. Pretty low. The Glimmer Cape comes through though. They're going to back off. They have not bought back on the Ember yet, but they really have to realize Secret's all coming down mid. I imagine they are going to retreat to the safety of their base and try to wait this one out. Sineko, first, I'll head towards the shop. But Secret just charging with the smoke. Again, Bulba did instantly refresh. So they'll have that second Ravage ready to go for this push. Plenty of mana to work with. Arrow coming through. But remember, Na'Vi have quite a few BKBs here.
They have all the spam against that and Enchantress there, grabbing one of the illusions away. It's gonna buy enough time for Dayara to respond, so all things considered, Na'Vi gonna be feeling lucky that they did not have to use the buyback on Dayara.
And we haven't talked too much about Arcs. Also,
Arrow
on the general. They're gonna put him under with the Wyvern, the Embrace, as well as the Glimmer Cape. Can they follow this up? They have slept him too, but so strong defensively, this Na'Vi lineup on the high ground, that Secret don't even care to risk it. They settle for a tier 3 tower. They do not force the buyback.
Yep, Na'Vi is starting to feel more in control in this game. I mean, I would even say they are in almost total control of the game.
That was with their one position carry dying with 70 seconds, Secret take only a tier 3, and he didn't buy back.
Yeah. They wish they had their refresher in that fight, you know. Now, Secret, I doubt Secret would get anything better than the previous opportunities to push the high ground.
And true to form, Na'Vi, they love to be aggressive in these situations,
courier.
And they're gonna find a courier! Manta Star recipe, not the biggest loss. Thought it had something more on it.
I mean, at this stage,
every
little bit is gonna be important to Secret. Like, every small item, everything they can get.
Not to mention, that's more money for an Na'Vi lineup that uses gold especially well.
Man, Secret is in dire straits right now. They have to be able to use the double Ravage to win a significant team fight.
Well, they're waiting on that second Ravage to cool down though. 50 seconds to go on the refresher. Na'Vi lurking bottom. Creep's starting to hit the tier 2. Playing this pretty safe winter. Not really in any hurry.
Yep, I think they kind of expect Secret to wait for their refresher, so Na'Vi themselves do not want to wait and fight at a bad timing, so they're choosing to fight. Most likely the safest place is their high ground, unless they can find a pickoff outside the base.
I mean, the two great things they have against the Tidehunter with a refresher are A, buyback, and B, BKBs. So I imagine...
Take
a look at Na'Vi.
They have the Moonlight Shadow into Ravage if they want to catch the Ember, so, I mean, that was what happened.
He's gonna have buyback, so I guess it's all about not getting hit by the second one at that point.
I mean, if you're Secret, you have to try and get that pick off, go to the high ground, force the buyback, and back off safely. That is what you have to do.
It's a lot of steps on the checklist at this point.
Yeah, everything has to happen correctly for Secret to be able to acquire a significant objective.
Yeah, Na'Vi, just so far, really, it seems like they just excel when they're in that hole and then teams try to go high ground on them. We've seen so many games this tournament, like the one game where they lost Mega Creeps, then they played their best Dota of the match, so.
I mean, in the team fights, the Kronos just always land on Boba. I mean, I'm not sure if we highlighted that significantly enough, but...
It does counter the Kraken Shell.
Yeah, the fights were difficult for Secret when Boba's caught in the Chronosphere, and...
Should he be sitting farther back, or is it just...
Yeah, he should.
Okay.
He should not be in the Chronosphere. Once he gets caught, Artstar is just gonna lay in on him, and he's just gonna die very quickly.
Oh, General. He's in the middle of Seeker right now. There's the Blake, the Ravage as well. Second one has been revved up. It is gonna connect, but the BKB's there for the Magnus, and he marches in. The RP finds Envy. They start shredding him. Envy's down. Bulba likely to be next, but they're looking for more of the Chrono now on the Pylai die, looking for the third kill of this fight. They've gotten two, but they need that Bulba kill as well to really make it a sweet victory. Arteezy leaping away, so they've used both Ravages now. Deira's alive. Na'Vi not even losing a hero, I think. Did anyone buy back there?
Yeah.
Did I miss something?
Enchantress bought
back. Enchantress bought back. I mean, hey, Na'Vi are happy with that.
I mean, they should be taking something big right now. Both Ravages use Secret using both their buybacks.
But can they fight with that? I mean, can they risk dying back without Ravages? The Chrono is going to come down, cooldown first. The RP as well. And the Winter's Curse not that far off. Arteezy trying to fend this one off. Secret are pretty much all in on this skirmish around the pit. Artstyle may end up dying back here. He will go down. The Enchantress out of the picture. General low. Will General die?
Where's
has not he gotten impatient? He blinks out to safety. Can they find him in time? He TP's home.
Where's the detection?
Do they have anything?
Not again. They have no sentries, no gem, nothing.
They have sentries on Pi. One sentry right now. And he hears your cry and buys more Winter.
How many kills have they not gotten because they do not have sentries on their heroes?
Enough that he
bought. Oh shit!
Oh my god. Blink. And you'll miss it. Deira with the devastating crit. So now General looking to follow this up. He's got a Chrono ready to go. There is a disruption available, I believe. Pylai died there. And he purges General as well. But still, they're going to have a Winter's Curse ready to go. The Aegis quickly cracked and looking for more. Rolling on the Puppy. Trying to lock down Envy at the same time. The chains are there. He looks to run. But can he get out? The Gust comes through. He still retreats. But Deira is going to continue the chase. Blink and look for the slide. The RP as well. Off with your head, Secret. Say Na'Vi. Decapitating three heroes, getting rid of the Aegis as well. A brutal exchange for Secret, and Na'Vi, they're gonna have their cooldowns ready relatively soon here. I think Secret will only have one Ravage for this push.
That's why I say you don't go late game against this Na'Vi lineup. That was just one big
slide. Press W, hover your cursor over the pit, and then watch them melt. That's the power of the Ember at this stage. And he's got 4,500 gold, by the way, so Deira is ready for another item soon. With the Empower now hitting for close to, in fact, a bit over 400 a pop before the crit. And he blinks in. He just slices up another. Pylai die. quickly turned into Sushi, and now Puppy getting blink skewered back. Dendi, no mercy for his old teammate. He does not get off the BKB here though, and he gets ravaged, caught out a bit. Actually, looks like it's still cooling down. There's the chains on the Puppy, can't finish the job. General waiting for his chrono, 15 seconds, but Na'Vi, they get out. They will have a chance for those ultimates to become available, and Secret will be minus a ravage.
Oh dear, this is right now Na'Vi's game to lose.
They're playing around these secret cooldowns so well, and at this point it's so easy for the Ember to find pickoffs. It's starting to feel like Secret, the walls are closing in.
There's one more fight remaining in Secret. If they do not win the next fight, the game is just going to be over for them. There's one last chance for them with the next double ravage. And even if they land a like a two-man ravage, I'm not sure if it's going to be enough. They need more than two. The last fight they landed two-man double ravage, but they still lost that fight.
It feels like they need like two four-man ravages right now. Or at the very least an Ember and then another important target.
Yeah, but if Ember plays his cards right, he should not get caught, so...
And again, he's going to have buyback even if he does. And likely a Remnant ready to go. So you've really got to find a way to kill him the second
time. If he doesn't want to get caught at all, he should get the BKB.
Yeah.
If he's
feels
not,
like the safe option.
Yeah, if he's not controlling the fights, there's no way the Drow can finish him off. Like, he's just gonna be able to run around with the Remnant.
The Drow is not really that farmed. Envy's 14k net worth at this point.
He's getting Lincoln's or Skadi on the Ember.
Yeah, so just gonna tank up a bit. Yeah, we don't see that Butterfly on the Drow. No true, like, pure DPS item. Just kind of cheap stats to Sneeko.
So every ulti up...
sneaks in, creeps up, gets the ward down under cover of smoke. Na'Vi looking for the killing blow here on Secret. Ooh. And as they go for the D-Ward, he strikes Dendi, Blake, RP, Skewer on back, piling in the knock him down. Can they get Arteezy as well? Good use of the shotgun, not gonna matter. Na'Vi cleaning up, and Secret on their last legs. The chrono to boot, it actually holds Diggy on position. Not ideal. Boba's gonna try for this, but even the curse is there to deny him as well. There will be no turnaround. Bulba ravages, but it's all for nothing as Na'Vi hold the high ground, and again, they best Secret down the stretch as the game grows late. What a performance by Na'Vi.
Well, two games in a row, I think Secret had a timing lineup where they had the lead in the early game, but then when they were pushing, they made mistakes, and they just got punished by Na'Vi. I'm not sure if Secret won.